Today, we're working on our drive system controller, which is the electronic component that takes input from the pedal and tells the batteries how much juice to give the motor.
We've got parts from China, Japan, Hungary, Oceania, probably even some places as exotic as America.
This was only worth $30, apparently, for customs purposes, and it was a gift.
Donashtin Georgi.
That's my favorite kind of orgy.
Some stuff.
Is this duck sauce?
Hungary, so it's probably like a paprikash kind of sauce. Thermal grease.
Huh?
Is the controller just capacitors? This doesn't look like what I would consider.
There's the on the other side.
Okay.
Yeah.
This, I think, is just a heat sink.
And this is the actual. There's switches down there.
So these are going to be the control terminals.
Do we really need these?
This silica gel's nickname is Do Not Eat. I really hate it when people use quotation marks as emphasis.
We have a controller. We have a motor. We have a potentiometer pedal.
We have the most important
thing. We have burp water.
So we've got a diagram of the controller, and it has a speed ground, which is a faster kind of ground, and it has a speed in, which is how you go in quickly. We think our throttle pedal goes here because it says throttle, and then if we have a brake potentiometer for regen, it would go here. It looks like we have to wire our 5-volt power in probably to our pedal, maybe to the ground from there.
Trying to figure out how this potentiometer works with this multimeter, we thought, well, we'd give it some extra voltage, so we wired it to this little phone charger thing, and we're trying to figure out why we're not getting any voltage out of it, and it's because this is off. We've got the power coming in, going to here. This terminal, which is checking our voltage, this is our ground here. When I push the pedal, the voltage changes.
Oh no, I want to whiteboard, but it's too far.
Now that we know how the potentiometer works, we're gonna have to hook the batteries up to the controller because we need more than 20 volts before it'll do anything at all. So we're just gonna wire 8 of our batteries in series to give us 24 volts.
What you do when you have the batteries here is you just wire them all in one big circle. And then after they're wired in a circle, what they need to do is they need to warm up a little bit. Go have a snack, spend about half an hour, and then you can come back.
So we're getting the low voltage end of our controller here hooked up. This lovely pedal, terminal blocks. The colors mean nothing here, but really we're hooking up positive 5 volts DC and a ground, following the manufacturer's wiring diagram to get the pedal incorporated into the circuit to tell the controller how much juice to give the motor.
Jason seems like he might think this is done right. I have no input at all. I do like this though, this whole, this is how we connect these three jumpers. So we have our high voltage cables, but they are not terminated and we don't have a means of terminating them. So we're gonna use this cable that's clearly meant to handle very high voltages, as you find in audio systems.
Twisting these together?
That's a viable solution. We don't need stereo for this. We don't have a 300 amp fuse, which we're supposed to have for this, but we figured the cable's probably just our fuse. A bunch of stuff that we need that we don't have, because we don't plan. We are a little bit afraid that all these batteries will fry this controller if we don't have a fuse or something as a failsafe. So we're not going to test that part of the controller right now. What we can do is we can make a little shopping list of the stuff that we need.
You can't just like flip a switch and connect the battery system directly to the controller all in one go, because the relay that does that will arc. So there's a bunch of really hungry capacitors in the controller, and they're trying to suck up current from the batteries as quickly as they can to fill themselves up. If you do that across just one relay, what happens is before the relay closes, there's an arc of electricity, and it's sometimes powerful enough to weld the relay shut, and then you have an always-on connection between the batteries and the controller, which you don't want. You install what's called a pre-charge resistor and relay. I'll show you on our digital whiteboard.
Hungry capacitors is,
So this is kind of how it works. Start a new schematic.
Ideas.
We've got stuff coming from our batteries here. The normal relay, the controller. So this is the one you don't want to close because it will arc. Another one here, and then there's another relay here which can be weaker, and it will go to there. And then there's a resistor which goes in right here. This top part slows down the charging speed of the capacitors by putting a resistor in line. Once the capacitors are mostly charged, then you can close this relay.
While we waited for the new parts to arrive, there was still plenty to do.
Our motor controller calls for a heatsink that's 200 by 80 millimeters. Had trouble finding a heatsink in exactly that dimension, so we got 8 of these 60 by 60 millimeter heatsinks, and the plan is to attach them to an aluminum plate with some thermal grease in between the parts so that the heat can conduct through them. Then we'll screw them in and then screw that plate onto the controller. We need about 480 millimeters of aluminum if we wanted to double this up. Because this is a 24-inch sheet, that's not quite what we need.
My granddad's clamp, wearing my granddad's cool safety glasses.
Safety and fashion in one item.
Oh, you're not plugged in, buddy. Oh, I was rolling for that. That's going on the video. Big brain genius is building an electric car.
You're gonna get the sparks over
Do I not want to be here? Okay. This piece has a use too. We could turn it into one of those sticks that you stick down through the window to unlock your car. There's actually one of those lost in the door of my car from the time it got broken into. You can hear it rattling. Thank the Imperial Measurement System for us needing a piece that tiny. Whoa.
I'm gonna like sandwich these together, file off the edges, put a little punch where each hole needs to go. We have the heat sink plate that we're mounting these heat sinks on, and then we have these machine screws here. Since these, I already tapped these, we're gonna mark where the holes need to go on the plate with this awl. Drill the holes with the drill press, thread these screws in from the bottom of the plate into the heat sinks, and the heat sinks are kind of like the nut that holds everything together.
Stop. Hammer time. Oh, that's not good.
Yeah, that drill bit's bent. That's better. Just got a sacrificial piece of wood. Sinking these holes now. Basically just using a larger drill bit than we used before. That way we'll kind of get this conical profile in the hole. But we don't want to go the whole way through the sheet because that'll just kind of mess up all these. We've gotten our sheet cut and we just finished countersinking all these holes. And the next step is just to clean up all these holes, file the edges.
A lot of this project is making holes and then filling them. And so like we need to start coming up with new jokes. I didn't get this on tape, but like I said, where are your bits? And he said, they're over here. And I said, yeah, what about your drill bits? And I don't know, we gotta work on it. That joke is a little easy. I'm lying, we keep making that joke.
Mais oui, il est le céramique d'or.
It's gonna take forever. This plunger is really difficult. Three parts here because the wonders of buying a 24-inch sheet of aluminum and then trying to get 200 millimeters out of it. They're like 4 millimeters off.
There was literally a Mars probe that crashed because of Imperial metric conversions. This is the exact same situation.
Jason's just drawing a crude picture of a car. Two. Is that like...
Those are cleaners. Cleaner. It's if you needed to
I want to use that bank card again.
Yeah, this will stain it. It'll seep in, so I hope you don't want
to
use it.
No, again. No. It's okay. Clearly... I tried to use it to open a locked door before, and that's why it's beat up.
It would be pretty funny if you came down partway through this, and you're like, what the fuck are you doing with my card?
Is we could put the cap on it, put it in a bowl of warm water.
Yeah, that is slightly more sane.
Dave was talking about microwaving.
Because we want to soften it up. It's just a way to introduce heat.
I really would not put this in anything you intend to eat out of ever again.
Guys, we can poop better now. Jason does all the work, we just make noises.
The best thing about it is we don't even need to make sound effects because I can literally edit them in and we feel compelled to do it anyway.
Paste sort of shittily smeared on our aluminum plate. Now we're going to sandwich it on.
We got championship smears.
Just the little...
Yeah, for those of you who cleverly noticed that it wasn't quite long enough. Ah, we're one step ahead of you.
Next step is to do this process for the heat sinks to put them on this plate.
On the first sheet, we had like a scientific system. We made a little grid. On this one, just kind of putting the spooge everywhere. This is macaroni art for adults.
This piece of bread is nearly completely covered.
Mayonnaise. It's good.
It's definitely not the light mayonnaise.
I'll have this with a side of computer chips. Am I right?
No.
So Tom and I have been playing Mario Kart while Jason works.
And we do mean Mario Kart.
The original.
JDM console, JDM truck.
We have a paste on the other side of the sandwich. Time to do this now.
So in a way, both groups of us did very well.
Line all these holes and screw everything in. I'm gonna let somebody without grease all over them screw this in.
Screwing all kinds of holes.
Jason's got his fingerprints all over this. If someone committed a crime in the Acty and we didn't clean this off, then it would be traced back to him.
I mean, there's a possibility I would be committing the crime, too.
Admitted to that on video. It would also, I think, point back to us that this is the only car that looks like this. But then it occurred to me that probably no one watches our YouTube channel.
I think I figured out why nobody watches. The final screw.
Well, that's not off to a great start. This is the worst
it's
one.
It's a messy finish. I swear this doesn't usually happen.
31 screw turns. And there we go. This one.
It's like when they were making the Intercontinental Railroad. They put
like
in
that,
the last, yeah, yeah, it's exactly like that. They put in the last gold spike, and it was like the leader of the company or whatever, and he like fucked it up. And of course, they went in after and they took it out and put a real spike in.
Life.
No, exactly. He didn't know how to swing. That's all his workers were like, well, fucking ding dong.
That's pretty good.
Third
uh-huh.
of the price of buying it properly.
Gonna wipe off all this shit. It is about 25 millimeters. All the heats can be generated.
Right
here, so that's why we have to bolt it onto there.
Let's see. Well, we made marks.
The heatsink is on the controller now. So we have this big aluminum bar that all the transistors are thermally bonded to. We use that as the mounting point. There's four holes there that are kind of recessed. The bolts go straight through there. There's also on the other side a couple sort of crappy looking standoffs that I made out of bolts and nylon spacers. That gives us a little bit more support. We put some thermal grease in between that bar and the heatsink assembly so that everything conducts heat the way we want it to.
Show your support for mini trucks with a sticker from our store. We also have a GoFundMe. The links are in the description. Join us next time as we wrangle with an uncooperative battery management system, which was originally supposed to be part of this video, but which caused so many problems that it had to be separated into its own video.
We're drawn outside by what we thought was a bird. Not a bird.
I wonder what he's so mad about.
Someone stole his acorns.